In this video, I'm going to show you how to upload Captivate and Storyline projects to your Google Cloud Storage, and I'll show you how to find the file that you need to link to so that you can share that link out, either to put it into your portfolio, to email it to someone, to give someone else access to your projects. So go ahead, log into your Google Cloud Storage, and head to your console. I'm going to go ahead and create a new bucket. So go ahead, create a bucket. Your name has to be unique. Let's call it Lindsay Test. I know. Perfect, that one's available. I'm going to leave all the settings as they are, except for this one. Just to make sure everything works entirely correctly, I'm going to set the permissions uniformly at the bucket level. That means I won't be able to change the permissions for things that are within that bucket. That's fine with me. I just want to make sure everything is available to view. Create. Great. So now we're inside of my bucket, but I want to go back and set the permissions at the bucket level. So I'm going to back out of this by clicking the back arrow. And this is the bucket right here that I just created. So I'm going to head over to the three dots on the right. And I'm going to edit bucket permissions. Okay, what I need to do here is I need to add members. I'm going to start typing in all users, all one word. And I'm going to select the option it's giving me here. And the reason is this has it capitalized correctly and it must be capitalized correctly to work. So I select that. And then I'm going to select a role and the role is going to be Storage Object Viewer. That means that all users that try to access material in my bucket will be able to view the material in my bucket. So I select that, you can see that it checked. Click out of that and then click add. You must click add for this to go into effect. Okay, that's it. So it points out to you this bucket is public and can be accessed by anyone on the internet. Fine by me because I want to use this for my portfolio. Now I'm going to go back into my bucket by clicking on the bucket's name. And I am ready to go ahead and start uploading files and folders. When you publish a project with Captivate or Storyline, it creates a folder that has a whole bunch of files inside of it. All of those files are necessary for the project to work. Let me give you a quick example here. So I made a Captivate project on the Mount Whitney Trail. If I open up the published folder, you can see that there are subfolders, there's a variety of files here, and if I go into each of these folders, there's going to be a lot more files. There's somewhere around 180 files that make up this one project, and this isn't even a big project, it's a pretty small project. It's the same thing for Storyline projects. When you publish, it creates a folder, there's subfolders, there's a ton of other files in here as well. It's the same thing. It's about 200 and something files go into a Storyline project. So these are the two projects that I want to upload into my bucket so I can put them into my portfolio. So from the Google console here, I'm going to upload a folder. I'm going to go to the My Adobe Captivate Projects folder and I'm going to select the Explore Whitney folder. Again, this is the folder that has the entire published project inside of it. And then I'm going to click Upload. Yes, I want to trust this site. I'm going to go ahead and upload that. So it takes a moment to process, and then a pop-up window will appear in the bottom right. And it shows you its process so far. You can see that there are 172 files and subfolders that make up this Adobe Captivate project. While it's doing that, I'm going to go ahead and start the next upload. Click Upload Folder again. I'm going to back out of that and go to my Articulate projects. and I want to upload this tutorial I made on how to do library research. So this is the folder that contains all of the files inside of it. So you just want to click on the main folder and then upload. Yes, again, I'm going to trust this site. I'm going to upload all of this. And that one actually had something like 368 files and folders inside of it. It's quite a bit. Again, it's processing. It updated the queue below. So now there's 540 files all together just to upload a Captivate project and a Storyline project. So I'm going to go ahead and speed up this video so you don't have to watch all these upload. Okay, through the power of movie magic, all 540 files are now uploaded. And go ahead and close that little pop-up. Now, I've got a WordPress site where I keep my portfolio, and I'm adding an example post to show you how to add these as links. So I've got some text already set up for Adobe Captivate, Explore the Mount Whitney Trails, the name of the project, Articulate Storyline, Learn to Do Library Research. So I'm going to pop back over here. This bucket's already made public. You can see it notes up here. It's public. All the files are uploaded. So what I can do now is enter the Captivate project about Mount Whitney, find the index.html file, and this is the file that you're going to provide the link to. This is the file that launches the whole rest of the project. Again, there's something like 180 files and folders in here. All you need to provide the link to is index.html, and that will provide everything you need to launch the project. So this is all you have to worry about. You'll notice it's got this little tiny chain link here. If you click on it, I'll go ahead and open it in a new tab. You'll be able to view your project. This is a good opportunity to make sure you've uploaded the correct thing and it is working. Looks great. Looks like it's working to me. Okay, so from here, I can either copy the web address from the browser bar, or you can go back here, make sure in the index.html file. You can also right-click and copy link address. Now I'm going to pop over to my new post. This is what I wanted to link, the Adobe Captivate project. I can click the Insert Edit link. I can paste in the link here. All right, so that one's done. Now I want to link the Storyline project. So I'll go ahead and close the Whitney project, go back to the bucket. Because I got to re-enter. Go into the Storyline project here. Now for this one, it's got a lot more files to look at here. It's kind of an overwhelming amount of content. I am looking for the main story.html file. This project was published in both Flash and HTML5, but I don't have to make a choice on which one I want to share. I'm going to share the story.html file. This is the equivalent of the Captivate index.html file. This is the file that I need to provide the link to that will call up everything else necessary. It'll actually make the choice between Flash and HTML5 based on the user's browser. I don't have to make that choice. This will automatically make that choice for me, and it'll call everything else up that's necessary. So same deal, make sure you're on the right file here. I can open this in a new tab, make sure it is working. All right, looks good to me. Again, I can copy the link from up here. Actually, I guess I should click through and make sure it works. Yep, looks good to me. Or I can go back here, right-click on the chain link and copy link address. Head back over to my WordPress post, highlight the text that I want to hyperlink, and then paste it in. Okay. Now, if I wanted to make this look a little bit nicer, I could actually take a screenshot of the title slide of this and paste in the title slide to my WordPress post and then hyperlink the title slide. That's also a really nice way to do it. But for right now, for example purposes, this is fine. I want to make sure these links work, so I'm going to hit preview. It opens up the preview in a new tab. And let's take a look here. So I'm going to open that in a new tab. Great. There it is. That's fantastic. I'll close that out. I'm going to open up the Storyline project in a new tab. Great. That's it. I can see that those links work. I know that if I share these with my learners, they should work. Oh, if you want to make sure that they work with someone that's not you, because I am still logged into my Google Console, you can actually copy one of the links. You can open a new incognito window. All browsers have some version of the private window or incognito window. You can paste in the link, hit enter, and make sure it comes up. Sometimes it can happen that you can access a project, but someone else can't, and that's because you're still logged in to whatever service it is. So I like to always test out my projects in an incognito window. Usually I will go and test out my project in a variety of browsers, both on Mac and Windows, just to make sure everyone can access it and it's no problem. You might want to try pulling it up on your mobile device as well to see how it looks. But this looks good, so it looks like someone else that's not logged into my Google will be able to view it. That's exactly what I wanted, and close that. And that's it. I'm good to go.